Hi, my name is Jenise Overmier and I'm an instruction librarian at the American University Library. I created this tutorial to teach you how to formulate a search query. If you have any questions about the tutorial, the research process, or you need help finding sources, you can reach me via the email address on the screen. What is a search query? A query is simply a question. So you can think of the search query as the question you're asking the information retrieval system, whether it's the internet or some sort of database. In order to successfully ask the question, you're going to need to learn a few quick tricks first. Boolean operators, the words and, or, not, and a few symbols, are words used as conjunctions to combine or exclude keywords in a search, resulting in more focused and productive results. Boolean operators are not necessary for a productive search. They're just one of the many ways to get the information you're seeking. That said, they're a powerful, simple tool that will save you time. Although the rules differ for individual search engines and databases, it's a good idea to use all caps when you use Boolean operators. Use AND when you want to join multiple words to narrow down your results. Think of AND as a way to weed out irrelevant articles. Use quotes when you want the keywords to appear as a phrase right next to each other. For example, if I entered the words millennial generation without quotation marks, I'll get results that contain the words together, but I'll also get results that just contain the word millennial, as well as results that just contain the word generation. This is also known as phrase searching. Use the asterisk when you want your results to include variant suffixes of your keyword. For example, if I use the search query on the screen, the search results would include the plural and possessive forms of the word millennial. When I'm doing research, I often make myself a search log, like the one you see on the screen, to help me keep track of what I've tried and what's gotten me good results, along with some information I've gleaned from the articles themselves. Otherwise, I find myself getting flustered because I often have 10 windows with 10 different searches open simultaneously. The search log is a tool to help you stay focused and save you some time. As always, if you have any questions, you can reach me at the email address at the beginning of the tutorial, you can chat with a librarian from the Ask a Librarian page, or you can come to see us at the library.